Hello, everybody.
Hey there.
Hey. Is everybody ready to hear some more guitar product? You've heard, I'm sure you've heard loads already. But I'm going to give you a little bit more.
A lot more polished.
Yeah. I think some people come in here just because the seats are nice, and it's actually just nicer and quieter in here. So I don't expect your full attention. You can sort of doze off a little bit as well. How are you doing?
I'm great.
It's been a little while since I saw you. So I'm Paul Hindmarsh. I worked for Line 6 for quite some time now. And it's my job today to go through the new HX effects. I'm sure you guys have seen it on all the nice flashing lights and the colors that we've introduced with Helix. HX effects is no different, so we've got a whole bunch of them around the booth there. An HX effect is a way of adding all of the Helix effect to your current setup or to your existing setup. So there is no amp models in there. It's just gonna do all of those effects. So there's 117 different effects built into it straight away as soon as you get it. We've also added 77 of the legacy effects. Does anybody have an M9 or an M13? Yeah, I was a big fan of that, and there was a few of those effects that were missing, but they're now going to be an HX effect. And anybody here who has Helix currently? Any of the Helix products? Yeah, the new update will give you all of those legacy effects and the new reverbs and everything as well. And we're going to hear some of those reverbs in a second. And the idea being that you can add it to your pedal, HX effects to your pedal board. It can completely replace your pedal board because you don't really need any more pedals. Or it can act as the centerpiece of your pedal board. So it can switch amplifiers, it can bring in external effects, and it can sit there quite happily and interact with your whole existing setup. So Helix effects or HX effects are all component modeled. So Line 6 over the last few years have become very, very good at taking classic pedals and modern pedals to pieces and actually analyzing exactly what those components do and making a little digital recreation of that signal path. Some of those things are notoriously difficult to model, silicone and germanium components. Line 6 has got a great process for making sure that everything sounds really, really natural and really, really analog as well. And it's one of the reasons why Helix has been such a big success. So you're also going to hear this today through two different amplifiers. We have a nice little tube amplifier here, a little 50-watt English amplifier. And I have one side that's running into a THR. And I'm just going to be using the THR as to get a bit of stereo spread and to make it a little bit sort of louder. I'm going to be running it in two different modes that you can probably see behind me, or maybe not. You will see it when I start playing. You have preset mode, where I can go through all the different presets. And then I have foot pedal mode, which is where I can see all the different colors and it works like a traditional stomp box. So currently, I'm not gonna do any guitar playing without any delay because that would be far too hard. So you're not gonna hear this bone dry. You're gonna hear a little bit of slap back between those two amps. I'm also got an expression pedal set up so I can pan between those amps, so I'll hopefully do some good stuff with that in a second. So the first thing I'm going to add to this is a kinky boost. Now apparently it sounds a little bit strange in my accent. The Northern English accent sounds good with the word kinky and boost. So here we go, one of the newer models from Helix. We have a bunch of different modulation effects in there. 60s bias trems. We've got tremolos. We have all kinds of tremolos, pattern tremolos, things that are going to bounce between different speakers, and also tremolos from classic amplifiers. And this is the bias one. Very organic sounding. It's not like you would expect in digital where everything's very, very even. Line 6 have found a way to change that to make it sound gooey and chewy. I think I've heard Americans use that term. Things like a strip mod phase. And a bit of Timmy on there as well. Thank you. Anybody who's seen me in any of the Line 6 demonstrators will probably know that Line 6 are very, very proud of the Univibe model. And it's a great thing to demo because if you're taking things to pieces and using component modeling, the original Univibe actually had a light bulb in there, and the light bulb changes the way that sounds. And the light bulb was never always the same. It never went from off to on in a straight line and very evenly. They actually have their own sort of curve as they get brighter, and that's the thing that makes it different every single time. So the ubiquitous vibe. HX Effect also has quite a comprehensive I/O on there. You have two different effects loops, and it's stereo all the way through. Now, the two different effects loops, you can have that configured as stereo, or you can have two mono loops on that. And that enables us to do a thing called four cable method, which looks like that. Has anybody run gear in four cable methods before? Are you sort of familiar with it? Yeah. So it's a great way of, if you have an amplifier that you really like the distortion on the amplifier and you want to add effects to that, it means that we can drop different effects into different positions of the amp. So we can run different effects into the front of your amplifier. It can then leave the amplifier and be processed with reverb or delay, and it keeps everything nice and clean. And it means that, because the last thing you want to do, if you've got a big long reverb, you don't want to plug it into the front of the amp and end up distorting that reverb and end up with a horrible sound. So this is now HX Effect running in four cable method with two different amps. And it's the new Glitz reverb. So one of the new HD reverbs there, nice and big. And you can hear that reverb is really nice and clean as well. Then we have the new Searchlights reverb. So that's a great way of running things. And you can also do that in seven cable method.
What's the name of the reverb?
So that was the Searchlights. It's one of the brand new HD ones there. So seven cable method looks a bit like this. Anybody know how many cables you need for seven cable method? Seven! What that also enables us to do is, so now I could have two different amplifiers with different effects in the loop and different effects running into the front of the amp as well. So you can have nine different effects on at once. So I could have a reverb and a delay in the loop of this amp, a different reverb and delay into the loop of this amp, and then different distortions or some kind of modulation block running into stereo there. We can also do... In fact, let's go into stereo now. So now you're not just hearing two amplifiers, you're going to be hearing stereo. Guitars get in stereo, it starts to sound really big, doesn't it? I mean, the original traditional amplifiers, which were always running in mono, and now after years of demonstrating Helix, I feel like I need to have stereo effect bouncing around. It makes such a big difference. So you guys at the front, you're going to hear that? Hopefully everybody at the back as well, we can hear some things bouncing around. Again, that's one of the new HD reverb. To the plateau reverb. Yeah. So your Helix user, you've got some good stuff coming your way. And people are about to buy HX Effects, you're also gonna have some good stuff coming your way. Then we can start having things like using the stereo blocks, so we can start adding stereo chorus to things like that. Just in mono. Just a bit of delay on that. guitar player. However, we have some great effects in there, like unique Line 6 ones, because Line 6 don't only model and recreate tradition, you know, other people's effects. We actually create a lot of our own as well. So this is the harmony delay. It actually sounds like I know what I'm doing, doesn't it? We have things like the bleat chop trem, so one of the more unusual tremolos we talked about. So it's a tremolo, obviously you hear him bouncing between the two. We have wet, dry, wet setups. Does anybody run wet, dry, wet setups? Yeah. Cool, well the HX effect is going to allow you to do that as well. Now I've only got two amps running here, but I can have this so this amp's completely dry and the reverb is just going to be coming through this amp here. And that gives you that kind of studio thing where again you want your reverb and your delay nice and clear. Nice and clear. So again, hopefully you can hear that. This is all dry on this side. Over here, we can have now Eric Klein from Line 6 programmed this effect the other day. I'm going to get him to program all of my effects from now on because this is fairly glorious. Very glorious. There's two of the new reverbs and the multipass delay. M-series effects. Some of the effects that I was missing from that were the synth sounds. So again, dry sound, dry with delay. Dry to me is just with a little bit of delay because I can't. Without delay, it's too dry. And turn the guitar from sounding like that. Synth. That's cool, isn't it? That's nice, yeah. So we've got attack synth, we have synth-o-matic. Another one of my favorites from M-Series, and then synth strings. And you're going to end up with that. You have a Helix here?
Yeah,
so you'll have this very, 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 very soon. As part of Line 6's continuing providing updates and new firmware and stuff as well, you know, so you always have new toys to play with Line 6. So let's do something now. So we said that we had everything here is stereo, so or can be stereo or mono, but the looper can be stereo as well. Now, same as in the Helix, this means that I can actually put things, loop things, and actually have them in different points of the stereo field, which is really cool. So I can pan. And have things moving between different amplifiers and record. I'm going to switch over the guitar, and I'm going to record a quick loop in open D tuning, because for some reason, I don't play in open D. And I thought it would be a good idea to write a piece of music in open D and then come to NAMM and play it in front of a whole bunch of guitar players. Why not
put the pressure on?
No, you just wanted the red sparkle.
Yeah, I wish this was mine. This belongs to one of the guys in Line 6. That's a cool looking guitar. Through some of the effects we're going to hear. The 145 rotary speaker. And again, I can place that somewhere, wherever I feel like in the stereo field. I haven't quite decided yet, but... You can hear the megaphone sound, so the overdrive is actually meant to sound a little bit weird and a little bit broken. And things like tremolo and some different overdrives and the solo at the top of that as well. So. HX Effects has to be very, very easy to use, and luckily it is, just in the same way that Helix is easy to use. So let's go through a little bit of the operation or the interactions you might have with. So here is a one that I prepared earlier. You can see on the top we have color-coded LEDs, so it's nice and clear and easy to use live. So I can immediately see that, although it, on the scribble strips it says optical trem there, because of the color blue, I immediately know that that is gonna be some kind of modulation. I know that this is a reverb because it's orange. I know this is yellow, so it's gonna be one of the drive effects. So on a dark stage, it's really quick and easy to see what's gonna happen. Scribble strips, you can color, you can name those anything you like. So if you wanna offend the singer or offend the other guitar player, you can light those up with you with custom colors and custom words on there as well. And it also has touch capacitance, touch foot switches as well. So anything that I touch there, I'm gonna see three different parameters. Those three different parameters are immediately changeable with these three pots at the top there as well. So it's just as easy, if not as, or if easier than actually using a real, using traditional pedals on a pedal board. If I wanna see, as you can see, that's switching in and activating different effects. Touching the foot switch just selects the effects, but if I wanna see all of the parameters for the pedal at once, if I touch and hold that, it's gonna spill out all those parameters so I can see every single parameter at once. So you can always see exactly what's going on. As well as being able to edit like that, what you can also do is you can actually go into something called pedal edit mode. Now pedal edit mode means that I can change any parameter on this without actually having to stop playing guitar. So I can be jamming along, doing a solo, and I might decide that I want a little bit more delay, or I might wanna change the speed of the chorus. Might have plenty of things to think about during this wonderful solo that I'm doing. So by holding this down, I enter pedal edit mode. Pedal edit mode's now asking me which one of the effects I want to change. And I'm gonna reset delay, so I'm gonna switch on that, change the delay. Mix is over here, I'm gonna press that with my imaginary foot, and then I can change the value of that parameter there as well. So things that you couldn't do with a traditional pedal board unless you were barefoot and you were, had really good toes that would wrap around different, really bad toes, I suppose it would be if you were gonna wrap them around particular. I'm going off on the wrong track now. So let's say I wanted to build a pedal board out of nothing. So preset view here. See if I can find a blank. So this is a completely, there's no effect in there. It's completely blank so far. I'm going to assign this in the, as the first one on the chain. And let's say I want to have some kind of compressor in there. So press that. Press this down, move it down to the dynamic effect. Then I get the option of mono, stereo, or legacy. Legacy being the older M series effect. And then once we're on there, I choose the actual type of compressor. And now it's named it and it's color-coded it yellow. If I want to put a delay at the end of the chain, I'm gonna touch that, I'm gonna press it in, I'm gonna switch down to delay, choose mono or stereo or legacy, enter that, and now there's a delay set up there, and all I have to do is save that. So it's it might not be as much fun, but it's a lot easier than going to a guitar store and buying 117 pedals and having to take them all out of the box and read the instructions and plug the batteries in and the cables and everything as well. It's all less straight away. Same as the Helix, if I want to assign an expression pedal to that, so if I want to assign the mix of that, of the delay to an expression pedal, plug your expression pedal or your controller in there, mix is over here, press this down, it's gonna say learn controller, I'm gonna press learn controller, move the controller, and then that's that assigned immediately to that as well. And I can assign a multiple assignment. So everything that everybody loves about the Helix with all of its ease of use, we've brought over into HX Effect as well.
Yep.
So you
can do nine effects at once?
Nine effects at once, yeah.
Six switches.
Yes, so there's six switches. You have nine effects at once, on the assumption really that you may not need to edit or switch on some effect, like delay being a perfect one. I'm not gonna do anything without a delay. So I'm happy to have that just switched on all the time. It may be a noise gate that you wanna have on all the time. It may be a reverb that's just gonna be there sitting there. So you've got instant access to those six, yeah. Then we have the ins, outs, in, outs on the back. So it's pretty comprehensive for a small pedal. You have two expression pedal inputs. Now those expression pedal inputs can also control an amplifier or control two different amplifiers. So if you have a particular amplifier you want to use, I'm sure you will, you want to use HX Effect with, it can channel change and switch the reverb on and off within each preset on there as well. Or you could use an expression pedal and have a wah pedal on there and have the channel change it for the amp as well. And that information can be sent out as soon as you change preset, HX Effects will change your amp, switch in your amp reverb, bring in external pedals as well. We've got a Boss DS1 pedal sitting on here. That's just sitting in the effects loop and I can switch that in and out as well. The two effects loops are mono, but you can configure them in stereo as well. Or you could use them as instruments or line inputs. So again, same as the Helix, you can reconfigure those to use whichever way you want. And the input to stereo inputs and stereo outputs, again, configurable between instrument level and line level. So if you're a DJ or you're a keyboard player or a producer who just wants to add a whole bunch of outboard effects to your studio setup, it doesn't have to be just used for guitar players with traditional amplifiers. You can use it for all kinds of different things. Then we have MIDI in and out, and that will send and receive MIDI commands. So getting back to the idea of being the centerpiece of your rig, if you've got a MIDI amp that's going to channel change via MIDI, or you want to send messages to this so that this changes over, it's going to do all that and it's going to control all those bits of gear as well. And then USB, because it will take firmware updates, obviously, and you have HX Edit software as well. So the same software that guys are currently using for Helix, you'll be able to copy and paste those pedals straight from one unit to the other. Obviously, it has to look a little bit different because HX Effects has no amp models in there, it's just the effect side. So it will ultimately look a little bit different. Okay, so I think, has anybody got any questions so far?
Yeah.
Can you
give us a little Aussie today?
There's no Aussie today, actually. No, there's no backing track stuff at all. I thought trying to play an open D on a stage in front of a load of guitar players who are probably all better than me would be enough.
Last year you gave us Bark at the Moon.
I know, you had Bark at the Moon, you had a little bit of Duran Duran, you had...
Yeah, yeah.
You had a load of Rolling Stones, yeah. No, sorry. I'm sure you still got it on video, right? I'm sure it's still up there. But I'm going to attempt to do another loop. So... tune this guitar up a little bit. Because there's... you don't really want to be out of tune in general anyway, but if you're doing a loop, your last thing you want is that guitar coming back at you in out of tune. Especially when it's an open D. Oh, I could just blame the tuning, couldn't I? So in here you're going to hear some stereo effects, you're going to hear some stereo chords. Nice tremolos, and I'm gonna again hopefully place this in different parts of the stereo field as well. So looping's a great thing to do. Professional demonstrator, I could have actually assigned some kind of fade out or an expression pedal for that, but I didn't. But so that was Paul Heimosch, that was HX Effect. Guys around the room are experts on this, you can speak to me about it as well. Thank you very much for your time.